All right. So thank you for coming, and I just love being here. This has been, I wanted to say to David, thank you for your dancing heart and your open mind. Because it's hard to keep your mind open. A woman who teaches Berkeley at UC, the psychology class on Psychology 101, 305, and she tries to get dreams in. She says, Gail, if you don't get to somebody by the freshman year of college, their minds are closed. They're closed largely about politics, but really about dreams. They've already decided who the guru is. Freshman year. And she's been teaching a long time. So when I meet more adult and achieved therapists and researchers, you know, are they really willing to look beyond what they already know? A lot aren't. They just keep doing their thing. And David was willing to read my stuff. And I so appreciate it. I just thank you very, very, very much. Because when you do a lot of glitz, and I love glitz, I never go even to the gym without lipstick. And I like to dance, and I like the romance. And I've got to do them both. But some people, one man who's no longer with us anymore, who used to be on the board, said, Gail, I just couldn't see through the glitz. Alan from Ottawa. And he said, then I got it. But hard for people to listen. So I know it's not hard for women, really. It's much harder for guys. And so I just haven't been willing. I tried to buy a Joyce Brothers suit when I started doing my TV work in 79. And I wanted to get a floppy beige thing with a suit over it in brown. And I went to the store and I couldn't even touch them. And it goes back to my early punishment from a Catholic nun in first grade. She called me up and slapped me across the face really hard, stung terribly. And all I had done was sit in the forward right seat, and Henry Vaccaro, my boyfriend, was in the back seat in the other corner. And Mom had sent me to school with brand new underpants with three rows of ruffles on them. They were so pretty, and so I was just showing them my love. It's been with me, and I just have to do both of those sides. Okay. So I love dreams about love and romance, and I suffer terribly how many people I know. I've been doing this for 40 years, where people don't come in to me for psychotherapy. I send them elsewhere for that. They come in to me to tell me their dreams. So every session is all dream work, all dreams for 40 years. And I have seen people have go in and make their bad marriage, come back 20 years later, I wish I'd listened to my dreams. So what I say is going to be mostly in the lingo of romance and love. But what's true about your being competent to be a good lover, or to spot who's a good lover, who's an incompetent lover, and that person's not competent in loving, that one is, that fits pretty true to your relating to colleagues. It fits very well to picking your friends. You have to be both a good giving of love and a good getting of love, but to have to get love by not just deserving it, but picking somebody who's competent to do it in the first place. So that's what this talk is about. Oh yeah, I could probably use my notes. Okay. Well, 4 years ago, I fell and cracked my head doing this. Something very much like this. This is post the cracked skull, because you can see I'm wearing a headband that protects me from future events. And I went to the ER doc. And he said, oh, you're fine. You can stand at 1 foot, you can turn around. And the four guys who came with me from the skating rink said, she could do that in her sleep without her head on, doctor. So I went home thinking I'd feel fine tomorrow. And Loma, my partner, is a psychiatrist in San Francisco at UC. And she was our first chairman of the board back in about 82 and 83 and 84, around there. And she's had three children who went through Kaiser Hospital emergency room meetings, just as I did. She wasn't so sure. She just came up. And by then, I had red blood under my eyes. And she said, why don't we write your doctor and see about going in for a scan? And he wrote back saying, well, Gail, don't worry. In about 3 weeks, you'll look just fine. So this wasn't a vanity call, doctor. Loma's here. When Loma says, I've got to do something, and you've got to do something, it's really hard to say no. She wants to know if you can rule out the following four horrible things have been going on in my head. Next email, why don't you come on up? We could do a CT scan. And what did we find out from the CT scan? That in fact I had a crack in my skull, that I didn't have any subdural bleeding or bleeding into my brain, that was a good thing, and it wasn't displaced. So we knew some things, that was good. That meant I didn't go skating for 2 years. And I was supposed to film an advertisement for a friend who had created lights underneath your blades so your skates glowed on the ice. And I was supposed to do that, then I would have done it. But you don't want to fall on a head that's been cracked. In fact, you don't want to fall on a head that hasn't been pretty well healed. Unlike other bones in your body, your skull doesn't heal as well ever. It's never what it used to be. Well, that's true about most things as we age, but anyway, I had to be careful. And really horrible things can happen to you. So what then becomes the question is, when can I skate again? Can I skate again? CT scans. They can come, they can look, they can see about the healing of the bone, they can see what else is going on. Well, 2 years, no, you couldn't. Third year. Don't worry, you're so old, it's not going to matter if you get a lot more radiation. And so have another CT scan. And then I could go skating again. So I owe a lot to CT scans. And I can't tell you how I do believe that you would all believe that's true about dreams. I think there's anyone who wouldn't agree about that. But do you really focus it in and use them for your love life, your friendship life, your colleague life, and your dreams? Freud was right, love and work. Boy, dreams are working on this, they'll batter on you for 20 years until you get it. First thing the dreams try to do is get you to look at the influences on your own competency of loving. That's number one. But also, then on the competency of the person you're picking up, is that person able to love? And just between you and me, women, I know that we've been in relationships. We think, well, we'll just give them another decade and we'll learn how to do it. Remember, that's a decade of your life. Okay, so these influences, I don't have to go over them all. But just run them through your mind. Your childhood influences, wounds, gifts, needs, satisfactions, the good things that happened. Your attitudes and your philosophy. Your willingness to rejection, loss, and pain. These are all absolutely crucial. There are a lot more things, but this is a good gathering. Your ability to reason. I'm really into reasoning and logical thinking. I think it serves us very well, and I try to tell people, reality is your best friend. And then we can learn from experience. If you say to a new guy you're going to date, well, what did you learn from your last relationship? And he says, well, she was such a bitch. Then it's probably time you don't have to explore it any further. You don't even need a degree on it, I would hope. Okay, and your ability to recognize your own repetitive patterns. And sometimes if you have good conversations on early dates, you find his repetitive patterns. Well, first wife, second wife, third wife, girlfriend. Oh, women are like this, men are like that. And then, of course, key point is your willingness to change and your dreams. You're interested in commenting on that fact, whether you are or not, and whether you're willing to make different kinds of choices. Dreams will show us where we are at a given moment if we're reenacting negative patterns. They don't seem to show you about reenacting positive patterns. I think well enough alone. I think that seems to be fine. And they do. People say, well, why do dreams focus on the negative? Because they're trying to help you get a better life. There are lots of times you will have dreams about your positive relational skills, and this is a really good woman, this is a good man. You'll have that. But somehow people remember their painful stuff, and they come in and ask me. They get their positive dreams. If you can focus on being practical, there are times for your floating discs. Why did you have the 5-minute sign up?
You have a lot more time, don't worry about it.
Oh my heavens, because we went over before I started, is that what happened?
Yeah, we started late.
Okay, well I'll just move along a little more quickly then. Okay, thank you. Okay, so, I don't know what I'm saying, but I want to say this. The creating useful dreams is automatic. We do it all the time, and we focus in on our love and our relationships. We know that. But do we really use them? Or do we hope that they'll Prince Charming's going to appear at our door. When the time is right, he'll find me. I assure you, women, that is not true. I mean, it might be true in a certain way, but in general, I wouldn't bet on it. I've been doing romance coaching for 20 years because I had so many wonderful dream clients who didn't know how to date. So, this is great. I'm just having lots of fun doing this. So understanding your dreams is not automatic. You do have to take the time, figure them out. I'm going to suggest doing a dream interview. There are lots of ways you can understand your dreams, but I'm doing what I do best because it fits my personality and my preferences. And I want you to find actionable insights. I'm not interested in just your wonderful dreams. I'm interested in your dreams that have you get a wonderful life. Oh, it helps so much. I once said to my ex-husband, who's a really good guy, you know, Steve, I want to solve this problem now because I don't want to have to dream about it tonight and then work on it tomorrow. And some things were easy to work on.